I hope I get answers.
Angie Pirtle returned here to the St. Louis Justice Center to see where her brother Kevin Cavins died November 8th.
He was a father. He was a very loving person. There's so much to say, but yet he's still not here. You know, it's one of those things that describing him just brings so much emotion. And I have him at home sitting in a box. That's all I have left of him. There's more that they could have done to prevent that.
Images of this month's riot renewed Pirtle's trauma, as she can only guess what happened to her brother inside. More than 100 days have passed since her brother died. Pirtle says she's treated as if he never existed.
As soon as I asked him questions as to what happened, I stopped receiving phone calls.
Some city leaders were surprised that Fox 2 knew about a jail death here this past November. When we started asking questions, the public safety director said they couldn't talk about it because of a lawsuit. We checked. There is no lawsuit. But Pirtle is starting to think that's what it's going to take to learn the truth.
The only reason I ended up obtaining a lawyer was due to the fact of them not giving me anything. Had they came out and told me, hey, this is what we believe happened, we're going to give you this evidence to prove what happened, I would have never even imagined getting a lawyer.
She got this police report that indicates her brother, who had just been brought in on a probation violation, was sick and that a jail medication was making him sicker. The report reads, Cavins mentioned he was having some type of negative reaction from the medication he was given by staff. Cavins informed correctional officers and nurses of this issue at least three times. Pirtle at first wondered if her brother was impacted by drugs. Three inmates were rushed to hospitals after simultaneously overdosing in the weeks following her brother's death. Corrections officers telling Fox 2 it's not uncommon.
I've never seen this amount of drugs in the jail.
Cavins' toxicology screen has not yet come back. Those results typically take 6 weeks. We're now entering week 15 with no answers about what may or may not have been in Cavins' system. Pirtle wants to know what the jail gave him that this police report indicates made her brother sicker. We'll continue following her fight for the truth as we now enter the 101st day with no answers from city leaders. For the Fox Files, I'm Chris Hayes.